1982.
Yeah, this is the foul on Mas.
Brilliantly cleared. Mawe Jetoni. Tony Maweje, he keeps coming. Very comfortable on the ball. Neat football there. Maweje does well. Maweje obviously, probably a contender for the player of the tournament for Uganda.
He's much bigger than his father was, and everybody thinks he belongs to Europe, and it's going to happen one day soon. About when they pull out, and when they stay back and defend deep.
Maweje twisting and turning. That was beautiful from Uganda coming. Maweje! And that's a new shot. Tony Maweje. Twice for Uganda in this tournament. He's open the score sheet. And here again, he got his opportunity. He got his range. And when he went for the shot, he almost was there.
It's a great play from Bengo. He sets up Maweje. The shot is really good. The goalkeeper, Duncan Ocheng, has no chance there if it's on target. Thankfully for him, it's a
sloppy play by Ouma. Tony Maweje. The referee says play on. Maweje. Nice stand by Maweje. Maweje. Driving through. He's brought down. He earns his team a free kick. But you wonder where Maweje gets all that confidence. Because he's a completely different player in this tournament. Smart.
Yeah, beats me. I just don't understand what happened to him. As soon as he came from Tanzania for the Tusker Cup, came in here, dominated. Look at this one. It's a great run. He sidesteps Edgar Ochen, the captain, and then it's brought down. Wins a free kick in a very good area, and he'll be a strong candidate to take it. He and Bengo have scored from such positions for Uganda already. But Maweje has been a different player at this tournament from the one that we thought was wasting his talent a year or two ago. Revelation, really. Big revelation. In that time when they were not playing international football, is at Mathare United, which is the most organized academy in Kenya, as well as in the whole of the region, was producing players. They were dominating the league and winning, and they were also giving Kenya...
2004, which was a suspension before the ban in 2006, because since then, the 2004, which was a suspension before the ban in 2006, because since then, they are 71st. So Uganda are three places. Well, I was just talking about this tie potentially going to penalties. After full time, it will go to extra time. And from extra time, it will go to penalties if it remains a draw. That was Maweje. Uganda are coming. Maweje! And that's a near shot. Tony Maweje. Twice for Uganda in this tournament. He's open the score sheet. And here again, he got his opportunity. He got his range. And when he went for the shot, he almost was there.
It's a great play from Bengo. He sets up Maweje. The shot is really good. The goalkeeper, Duncan Ocheng, has no chance there if it's on target. Thankfully for him, it's a
pass. Who really put up a performance in those penalty shoots, are very comfortable on the ball. Neat football there. Maweje does well. Maweje obviously, probably a contender for the player of the tournament for Uganda. Osborne Mandi.
Looking to chest that out. Mandi Osborne has a high boot up there and gets punished by the referee.
Maweje, who has already scored direct from a free kick, trying another long ranger. It's blocked and he wins a corner. But Maweje, really, what a revelation he's been at this tournament.
This guy has been a class act. He's being overshadowed by Omoni even in this game.
They have won the title on penalties twice. That was in 1989 against Malawi and in 1977 against Zambia. But Kenya have also won the SEKAFA tournament twice, actually.